Today, we're going to go over easy ways to hit your macros. And one of our wonderful students, lovely girl, she says, I'm struggling hitting my fat and carbs and macros. And for those of you that track macros, macros are fat, carbs, and protein that make up calories. They're a super, super easy way to eat whatever you want and look great. Micronutrients are more like the vitamins and minerals where, nutritionists will focus on those, but not necessarily geared for aesthetics.
I was not supposed to be successful. Hey there, Casey Shipp here, fitness model hormone expert and a master energy healer. I help goal-oriented women clear out the reason why nothing has worked and finally step into their purpose and get everything they've ever wanted.
I've been tracking macros on and off for, I mean, I've been in the game for 15 years, professional fitness model. I've got two kids via C-section. I've got a total hysterectomy. I'm almost 40 years old. And I got a better body actually after I had a hysterectomy and kids. And this is how I do it. I know how to balance my hormones. That last call we were on, we were talking about just the little bitty manipulations you can do. Like, I was really wanting this. I couldn't see like a line in my stomach, and all I did was adjust one hormone and my line came in. So sometimes, and I always say, here's how to lose weight without cardio. That's kind of like my thing, is lose weight without cardio, but it goes way beyond that. We have an approach that heals the nervous system, the patterns and the traumas that keep you stuck, keep the fat on, keep you going back yo-yo dieting. Like, we have a way to clear that out of your nervous system and your mind that kind of makes us different than other people. And we have hormones. We do hormones. We partnered with physicians. We biohack, we do food testing. And so when you learn how to manage and manipulate your hormones, as well as the science, because losing weight's easy. It really is. And don't shoot me. The part that's hard is maintaining and staying on track when life, things get thrown in your way, or little things happen. I mean, it happens, especially if you have kids or you work or whatever. That's what makes it hard. And it's emotions, it's emotional patterns, it's generational coding, it's all these things. When I say science, and food, and it's easy, it really is. And when you start to use these tools like biohacking and food test and learning how to, count your macros in a way that's based on your hormones, learning how to train based on your hormonal response, not just like everybody else, hey, three sets of 10, do this or this HIIT training, but actually knowing how to train based on where you're at hormonally and where you're at in life. Like, what season of life are you in? You get a lot of stress on you, you're pretty freed up. Like, there's a way to train. So you can't sit here and look at a woman that is banging it out in the gym and her kids are grown and they're, she's got teens. When you have a new baby, you can't compare yourself to these types of people because it's not the same. So with that being said, I wanted to share with you how I got really, really quick results lately, because 2023, I came off hormones. I did a lot of healing. I did a lot of plant medicine and I stopped tracking food and kind of ate vegan, and I got my IGF-1 dropped, my insulin growth factor dropped, all my hormones dropped. Like, I gained a lot of body fat. I had cellulite, all this stuff happened. And while I enjoyed like the more curvy feminine curves, I still like looking fit. I like seeing tone. I like seeing lines. And I just started working out again January. I still train. I did Pilates and I did dance and some exercise in last year, but my regular was way more than that, right? But I still promoted, here's how to lose weight without cardio in 15, 20 minutes. And I actually told a lady earlier about how we help women clear their autoimmune and their Hashimoto's with 15 minute workouts and actually eating more food. And it's really cool if you want it. All you gotta do is put answers or strategy in the chat, or DM me answers or strategy, and we will definitely get that over to you. But today it's about macros. So do I track macros? I am right now. Do you need to track macros to lose weight? No, I can't tell you. Out of all the women who work with me, a lot of them don't track macros and they lose weight. Tracking macros is great for those who you're a little busy and you don't eat enough, your energy's low or whatever. Like, it's almost like money. You have to track your money to know where your money's going, if you want to make more, how to have a budget. So you kind of are like that with your food. If you're really working on a health project, you kind of need to know what you're eating. You'll actually lose weight just from tracking your food. You'll be like, oh my God, I thought I was eating enough. I'm only eating 1200 calories. Holy crap. Because if you eat too little, that's not good. That's going to like ruin your metabolism. You're not going to have enough energy. And then you're going to make it all these, your neurotransmitters are going to drop. You're not going to be happy. Like, it's a downward spiral. So there's a way you reverse diet out of that and all that fun stuff. But that's not why we're here today. I wanted just to tell you a quick couple tips about macros. Being a busy woman, it's kind of hard sometimes to hit macros, especially if you're not used to eating enough food. So when women come to us and we start making them eat more food, they struggle hitting the carbs and fat. So here's how to do it. I told a lady today, I was like, here's what I do. So fat, one tablespoon tablespoon or 2 tablespoons of peanut butter is like, it's a lot of fat. Last night, I actually ate a whole thing of peanut butter, like to get in like 30 grams of fat because I was short on fat yesterday because I had been out about. I wasn't eating enough yesterday, so I just made sure to like get everything in at night and play macro Tetris pretty much. But one way, if you know you're struggling to hit fat and carbs, here's an easy way to do that. So in the morning when you make your shakes, and I use the blender bullet, that little cup that you just put all your stuff in, twist it upside down, turn it on. I will throw in my protein powder and use, here's a trick. If you need more carbs, start using things like rice milk, assuming you can have grain, assuming you can have rice. And if you want to know if you can have it, take the food and gut test. The link is in my bio, food and gut test. So take the food test, make sure you can have it. If you have Hashimoto's and stuff, like grain may not be ideal. There's a ton of other things you can add for extra carbs, tons of fruit and all that fun stuff. But add rice milk. It's really, really sweet and it has a lot of carbs. Number two, if you know you're short on fat, throw so much peanut butter, almond butter, chia seed, like throw so much fat in your morning shake. It's going to taste so good. Top everything with like crushed nuts, like all these amazing things. I know this is crazy. Even the bodybuilders are going to be like, what? You can even add things like orange juice. I know it's going to be calories for you. If you struggle hitting carbs, adding things like rice milk, orange juice, extra fruit and everything is going to really help you hit carbs. If you struggle hitting fats, just throw in a lot of peanut butter, almond butter, chia seed, avocados, sprinkle nuts on things, stuff like that. Coconut oil, like put that in your coffee if you drink coffee. Like there's a lot of ways to get more fat. So that's my tip on how to get more fats and how to get more carbs in your diet if you struggle and if you count macros. If you want any of the resources that we use, the hormones, the food and gut test, the actual macro calculator based on where you're at hormonally or the workouts, all you got to do is either go to the bio, click the link in the bio or in the description, or send me a DM to Instagram that says answers and we'll get it to you. Bye.